cosmetic change. He didn't consult with anybody in appointing this cabinet. So you cannot say there is consensus. There is public support to this government. These are, again, some puppets employed by a prime minister puppet that the same guy that is still running the show is the 90 years old man, Mahmoud Abbas. I know for fact that those who have turned down the invitation for the government are almost 10 times those who have accepted it. You know, now they couldn't find the Minister of Foreign Affairs. He tried to convince two important ambassadors, his ambassador in New York in the United Nations and his ambassador in Geneva in the other United Nations. Both of them declined, and they are ambassadors currently employed by him. So nobody is willing to take nobody seriously. A serious person will not accept the invitation for such a government, because this government is not convincing, not to the Palestinian people. It's not convincing to the world that is looking for real reform. And the real reform is simply by the is simply seeing the old man stepping down and passing the torch to a new generation. This is how Palestinians are expecting democracy.
And then what? Who are going to be the figures that will pop out?
Well, actually, we need to go to elections, but elections now are not possible because of the situation of Gaza. 45% of the population is not able to participate in an election. Until we get life back to Gaza, we cannot have elections. But at least now, he should be able to involve the opposition in Fatah, involve all the other political functions in the Palestinian political life, into forming up a government that is acceptable by everybody. The street would like to see Abbas giving all his power. You know, he is now issuing presidential decrees as laws because we don't have parliaments. He controls the judicial system. Corruption is still there. He didn't do any serious change. And until now, he is still holding the money. He is still holding the diplomacy. He is still holding the negotiations. He is still holding the foreign relations. He's still holding everything. Most of these ministers that have been appointed, they don't have budgets in their ministry. They cannot develop strategies or plans. They cannot develop projects that can serve the Palestinian people. Now, almost the PA is bankrupted. They don't have money. So what can this government do? How can he convince us that this is the change? And look at the government. Three women out of 18. Three out of 18. This is, I mean, even in cosmetics, he's not good. At least he should involve more women.
Well, yeah, maybe he took an example for the Israeli government, but that's a different issue. If I sum up your opinion here, very gloomy, no chance for real reforms until Mr. Abbas is gone?
Well, the Palestinians would like to see both Hamas and Abbas out of their life. Abbas has brought corruption to the West Bank, and Palestinians are suffering from this corruption. And Hamas has brought destruction over Gaza, and Palestinians are fed up from this destruction. Palestinians would like to see both of them leave the scene. Palestinians would like to see a leadership that is accountable, that is transparent, that is democratic, that is able to bring construction, development, hope to the Palestinian people. They are wishing to wake up every day and feel that today will be better than yesterday. Now every Palestinian wakes up in the morning and he's 100% sure that today is going to be worse than yesterday. So this is a lot of pressure over the Palestinians. And Abbas was not only a president for 19 years. He has been number two since 1965. Can you imagine that in the last 100 years, the Palestinians have had only three leaders, Haj Amin al-Husseini, and then Yasser Arafat, and then Mahmoud Abbas. For 100 years, only three leaders. This is terrible. And the Palestinians deserve to have a democratic leadership, deserve to have election every 4 years, deserve that young generations, we are a very young nation. 75% of our population is under 36 years old. We are a very young nation, and still he is 90 years old, and he is planning to continue maybe for another 10 years. He's holding all the jobs that is possible in the hand of one person.
Okay, and Samer Sinijlawi, I think I got the idea. What's your opinion about Mr. Abbas? I thank you very much for that. Thank you.